Another question is that I just saw here is somebody is asking, how long should I date?
It's a very good question. I will say this, that normally you want to think in terms of what do you want to know? That's why I say you've got to do your homework first. What do you want to know about this person? Now, think about it this way, Charles. We go for interviews for jobs. And the reason why they interview us for a job is so that they can find out whether we are a good fit for their company. And even us, we go for those interviews so that we can see whether they are a good fit for us to work for them. You see? So we take time to get to know the company. They take time to get to know us before we sign a contract to engage each other. So this is what we do for dating. It's the same thing. You need the time frame is not as important as what you are looking for. Do you know what you are looking for? And I'm not talking about the list we used to write when we were in high school, and you would write dark, tall, and handsome, and has money, and all that. I'm talking about values. I'm talking about character. I am talking about how they live their lives. What kind of people are they? And what kind of a person are you? Because you cannot, again, expect someone to be what you yourself are not. So if you expect me to be faithful, then you need to show me that you are faithful. So we need to find compatibility in the values, the people that we are. So how long should you date? Let's look at how a relationship grows. So I meet you, and the first month, the first week, the second week, we talk for 7 hours nonstop. I have been there, and we would talk on the phone. Well, you hung up. No, you hung up. And an hour later, we are still telling each other hang up because we are so excited. We are so interested in connecting with one another. That is the part of the relationship that we call the dream stage. During the dream stage of a relationship, that is not the time to make long-term decisions, because like I said, you are running on hormones, you are running on emotion. It is the chemical that is in your brain that is running the show. So you need to allow yourself to go through the process of coming down from the clouds so that you can be able to understand who this person really is. Because during the dream stage of a relationship, we are not able to objectively look at this person. We overlook their faults. We think that their quirks are cute. We don't, because again, at that point, we do not want to lose them. The excitement is great. So we don't want, even when we see the red flags, we don't want to lose them. So the first month of your dating relationship is not the time to move in together, and neither is it the time for you to be sexually active with that person. You need to give yourself time. So I normally say up to 3 months, if you can date and you can get to know each other, and especially if you know what you're looking for and you are staying balanced with the emotion, the chemistry, plus the objectivity of whether you are compatible with that person, that after 3 months, the relationship normally moves to another level. Naturally, it moves to a level of deepening the connection. So that now, even though you are not talking for 7 hours and 5 hours, if you talk for 1 hour, it still gives you that excitement and the feeling that that you are still connected with this person. So you continue with the relationship. At the 6 months, point of the relationship, that's when we begin to experience conflict. Normally, that's the way it goes. So 3 months, you are getting to know this person and you are getting to be able to reduce the amount of emotional responses and emotional reactivity towards the person. Then after the 3 month period, then you begin to really be more objective. There is the balance now. So I'm not shutting out all my girlfriends, not talking to them anymore. So I begin to continue with my life, and this becomes part of my life. It doesn't become everything for me, that I am moving to being more interdependent not dependent on the relationship. And then now at the 6 months, between the 4th month and the 6 months, you begin to have a bit of conflicts here and there. They may not be verbally said, or they may not lead to fights or anything like that, but they might go into questioning. This is a very important part of dating, when you begin to question what you are seeing. So you see the way that they make decisions. You see the way that when they are not happy, how they brood, how they turn off their phones, or you begin to see the real person. And during those 3 months, between month 3 and month 6, it's very important for you to be rational at that point, objectivity, and you begin to look at the person and to learn their values and how they deal with life. Now, at 6 months, that's when the relationship begins to ask for the next level, and the next level of dating is courtship. That is why women will ask the men, "What? Where are we going? How do you see us?" The relationship begins to ask, what is there? Point. What is the end goal? And so you can go to, after 6 months, for me, 6 months dating is good time for you to really get to know this person, to make the initial decision that this person looks like a person I could spend the rest of my life with. Now, at this point, then you need to communicate, "Hey, I have known you, this is what is going on, and this is what I am thinking," so that the two of you can see whether you agree. At that point, there will either be, "Me too, I feel the same way," and then you begin to develop goals for the relationship. That's when you enter into courtship, because courtship is where now you are courting each other towards marriage. Now, the people who date for 5 years, now, if you meet a person when you are 25, like I was suggesting, you don't have 5 years to date them, usually. But if you meet a person at 19, you're going to be together for 5-7 years, but the relationship is not growing, because you people are not mature enough to do these things I'm talking about. And so what happens is that these long relationships, they either end with a lot of heartache or they never end. So you keep going back and forth. You break up, you come back together, you break up, you come back together. That's why I say allow yourself to mature emotionally and even intellectually, so that you can, when you make the decision to go into long-term relationships, then you are in a place where you can answer the question why, and you can answer the question where, what, and when. So that now you're not just going with the flow and hoping and waiting for things to work themselves out. Relationships are worked out by two individuals. They just don't work themselves out. And also, if you are in a relationship, by the time you are 6 months into this relationship and you realize that your partner is suddenly pulling away from you, or they are not interested in the relationship, they are not telling you to break up or whatever, take that message and make your exit, because there is no need of being tagged along. And then you find yourself a year into the relationship, 2 years into the relationship, and the person has never made a commitment, whether there is, for them, they are making any choices for the future or not. Do not allow yourself to be strung along in a relationship that has no goals. If you have goals, and he doesn't have goals, or he or she, then it's time for you to tell yourself, "You know what, I need to decide what I want to do with my life." Take responsibility for yourself. Stop trying to change people who have decided how they want to live their lives. If they are not compatible with your goals, they are not compatible with your values, they are not compatible with where you want to go, walk away. Don't waste your time. And then here we are crying because now you are heartbroken because it has been 5 years of wasted time.